I love you, Ted. Tell Carly I love her too.
Well, Carly, I've got some good news for you, but I've also got some bad news for you today. The bad news is, it seems that you have the same heart condition as your mother, which would explain your sudden collapse at dance practice this morning. But the good news is, her heart's in still pretty good shape, so it's lucky we caught it early.
Jeez. Don't you usually ask if you want the good news or the bad news first?
Well, it's just standard...
It's okay. Just tell me Carly's gonna be fine.
Carly will be perfectly fine, provided that she stays away from any physical activity for the next few years. And that'll give us time to work on her new mechanical heart.
Will I still be able to dance, Daddy?
Don't worry. So what you're telling me is that if she takes it easy for a couple weeks, you'll be able to stitch her up with a new heart?
Well, not exactly, Ted. It's not that simple. Carly will have to stay inactive for about 3 years. That's assuming, That's assuming the 6 people ahead of her get their hearts first. It'll be fine. These things just take time.
So I won't be able to dance?
Don't worry. I won't let this heart problem take that away from you.
Don't worry. I'll figure this out. Just go to bed.
All right, then. Night, Dad.
Night.
What's in the box?
Not taking, give me the
What's
gun.
In the fucking box?
Fuck! Feels good.
Breaking news. A man awaiting a liver transplant was brutally murdered in his home last night. More on that at 10. In other news, President Barack Obama was arrested today for masturbating on the subway.
What's up? I'm on break. Make it quick.
Hey, Stan, glad you're still at work. I need you to do a favor for me.
Oh, hey, man, how's it going?
You should have seen I need you to take the heart transplant folder from Dr. Jeffrey's desk.
A pumpkin and denim. Wait, what?
It's just for one night. It's in the top left drawer of his desk.
Dude, are you serious? I've already been suspended because of the Percocet thing. I'm on thin
if you
ice
do this for me, there's
that.
A 2-4 in it for you. At my place.
Top left drawer? I'm on it.
So, you know all these people. Like, you've met them?
Yeah, that's kind of what nurses do, Ted. Why do you want the file, anyway?
Sildenafil citrate. What is that?
Oh, this poor bastard. You don't recognize the name?
No.
From adult films, you might recognize him, Lance Hardigan. He's got a clogged artery from, an overdose of sildenafil citrate, but... You might know that as Viagra.
Wait, no strenuous activity?
Can you imagine?
He's just gonna be out of work for a while. Hi, Mr. Hardigan?
Hi there. How did you find this place?
I'm a really big fan. Do you think you could sign this for me?
Come inside. I got a pen.
You know what? You were great in Bondage Babes 32.
Oh, yeah? What's your favorite scene?
Let me think. It's a tough one. I'm pretty sure it's the belt scene.
How about this other guy, Augustus Herzog? Says he's 350 pounds.
Oh, this Jabba the Hutt motherfucker. So, we're at the waiting room. Hours of fucking pizza to the waiting room at the doctor's, can you imagine? He comes in, Dr. Jeffrey's obviously he's gonna send him to the MRI. The guy's 450 pounds. Gets stuck in the fucking machine. Fucking idiot out of coma.
Wash
these
for me? I just need to
go take a dump. Oh no, man. Why did I have to wash
them? You can have as many as you want. Just make sure that there's a couple left for my daughter after I get back.
Alright, man. No problem. Have a good time.
Hey, thanks, man.
Hey, this Seamus McCready guy, he looks kind of familiar. Is he Irish?
Oh yeah, he works at St. Bernard's, the Catholic Church.
Strange how a man of God ends up with a heart problem.
St. Bernard's? You know what? I think Stacy used to go there. But she left because the priest stole a lot of money. Fuck. You know what? I guess karma's a bitch.
Excuse me, Father. I could use some guidance. I'm kind of busy here, son. I stole a lot of money from work. I mean, I really needed the money, but I just don't know what to do.
Greed is one of the seven deadly sins. Have you heard of Timothy 6:10?
Money is the root of all kinds of evil. You know what? I think you need this more than I do.
Toss me a beer, bud.
Let's see. Contestant number 4 on the Wheel of Misfortune is Emilio Corazon. Emilio, come on down.
What a brat.
Why? What's wrong with him?
He's walking around like he owns the place. Well, his dad owns the place, but still. He just walks around spending mom and dad's money on cocaine and hookers. The little jerk got exactly what's coming to him.
Jeez, tell me what you really feel about that guy.
He's a dick.
dog. I've been waiting for like an hour. What's the holdup, is it?
Sorry, I was just doing some stuff for my daughter. I do feel kind of bad though, so I added in a little extra for free. Here's the ounce you want. Nah? Come on, pay up first. 6 bills. Don't worry. It's to die for.
Hey, you know the guy from Dallas? The new guy? That's under,
Kurnoff.
Kurnoff, yeah.
Yeah, I know. He got me 68 goals last year in fantasy.
Well, his twin in that folder.
Really?
Yeah, miserable son of a bitch. Kind of hot-headed. Didn't like when I asked for his brother's signature. I think there's a little bit of jealousy, because he never made it out of the minors.
That sucks. I could have used another rookie to kick your ass again in fantasy.
Yeah.
Hey, you're Kurnoff, right?
Yes. What do you want?
You know, I'm just wondering, what happened to you? Your brother's a superstar, and you're just a fucking fry cook.
What the fuck did you say? You wanna say that to my face?
No! No, I think I'll just drive off. Because if you're as slow in that piece of shit truck as you are on the ice, I should have no problem.
You're dead.
Isn't it kind of messed up, out of all these people, the only one I feel sorry for is this little girl, Mako?
You don't need to feel sorry for her, Ted. She's the greatest dancer in the world. And she's not afraid to tell you. There's camera crews and media crews everywhere. It's like Brad and Angelina trying to adopt this chick, right? But, like, it's just bullshit, man. She'll never dance again.
Carly will.
Well, Carly, good news. And only good news today. It seems that you've made a full recovery from your heart surgery a few months ago, and you'll be perfectly fine now.
Really? Does this mean I could go back to dance?
It sure does.
Oh, Daddy, can we go right now? I miss it so much.
Sure, honey. Dr. Jeffries, I'm thinking of making a donation to your research. After all, you've helped out Carly so much these past couple months.
Hey, Dad. I'm sure you'll be happy to know that you no longer have to pay for my school.
Why is that?
Well, I got the Mako Kokoro Dance Scholarship. Looks like I'll be heading to Florida State. Riveting conversation as usual. Anyway, I'm off to Craig's house for the week. See ya.
Putting hand on the gates, we was jumping them fuck. I'm like quicksand in my ways. Was always stuck and I'm stuck it in, and our ambulance came. The first time was Shane Fast, few Los Angeles rays. My bitch say the spliff take the soul from me. And the click tighten it, it's like the low rugby. Beat the fucking beat up like it stole from me. You could talk to Clancy, you need a feature quote from me. I'm off the Lancy, I wreak a reefer and show money. It's early running with niggas who cold running shit. The wind's like lotion, he getting me going.